Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, I welcome you all to this video. We are with the second lecture of chapter number 9 for a microwave engineering subject, where the microwave transmission with the help of a single conductor transmission line, that it is circular waveguide, is to be addressed here. In the previous video, we have analyzed a scalar function represented phi as a spatial parameters rho and phi, taking into consideration the cylindrical coordinate system. We have derived it, and the further analysis in terms of the field vectors of electric and magnetic field intensities can be extended for coaxial transmission line. We take the circular waveguide to be the essential modification from the coaxial transmission line. So let us see the details for microwave propagation inside it. So here we start with our topic, microwave propagation in circular waveguides. So as the first term into the title of this topic is microwave, I hope it is very clear that it is basically electromagnetic wave with a particular frequency range from 1 GHz to 300 GHz. So we want to have the propagation of such basic electromagnetic wave or microwave with higher frequency ranges inside a circular waveguide. We have already gone through the complete analysis and practice with the device rectangular waveguide. So the meaning of waveguide is the same. So it is guiding the wave. So the guiding of the wave is with the help of total internal reflections inside a hollow cavity. So waveguide in general, what we define, it is a hollow metallic tube. It is the same here, but a change of cross-sectional shape here. So in this particular circular waveguide, we have the cross-section of circular type here. So let us see, this is a circular cross-section, and the length of the waveguide is like this. So this is a hollow metallic tube having circular cross-section. For analysis purpose, we can take the axis into consideration from the rectangular coordinate system as well as from the cylindrical coordinate system, we shall definitely discuss. So now we want to have the microwave to be inserted inside such a hollow metallic circular cross-section waveguide tube from one of the end, whereas another end will be at certain distance from it. So once the microwave is inside this particular cavity, we want not to allow the microwave to get radiated or to come out of any way from the walls of this circular waveguide. Hence, such a metallic tube is made up of possibly highest value of conductivity materials available. So this hollow metallic tube, now onwards we shall be calling a circular waveguide, is made up of perfect conductive walls in ideal case here. So as we know that the electromagnetic wave cannot penetrate inside the perfect conductors, it will be reflected back. Because when we are working with the transmission of energy inside a material that is of metal having higher conductivities, we have the information in terms of voltage or current there. Whereas in the wireless medium, unbound medium, I can say there it is in the form of either E or H, representing the corresponding electric field intensity and magnetic field intensity measured into volts per meter and then amperes per meter. So basically, antenna works as the interface between the two forms of the energies, but provided there should be a relationship of the dimension of that particular conductive material to the operating frequency or wavelength, we can say. If it is not, it is having a perfective conductive material, so inside there it is a microwave, it will be having a complete reflection inside. So if the microwave is incidenting on the upper wall, it will get it reflected to the down wall here. So again, it will be having reflection to the upper side, and if the length of the circular waveguide is there, it will be having the to and fro motion from all the walls that have been surrounding this particular hollow cavity. Most of possibly we consider the air to be the dielectric medium. So this is the circular waveguide. So for the further analysis into the subsequent topics, the dimensions we consider to be only one dimension for the circular cross section, that it is the radius, and we consider small a to be the variable to represent the radius of circular waveguide. So let us say this is x axis, this is y axis, this is z axis. We consider the microwave propagating in the positive z direction. So in that regard, we need to take this to be the negative side of the z axis. Here in this direction, there it will be the positive z direction, and from this end to the another, there it will be the microwave propagation inside it here. So as we know that in the unbound medium, the behavior of electric and magnetic field components. So basically we have a summary in the form of Maxwell's set of equation. Further, for having the harmonics to have the wave nature, we have the two wave equations in the unbound medium. So in the next lecture, we shall be having a solution to these wave equations when the medium is bounded to this much of limited cavity having radius small a, and the cavity is bounded by the perfect conducting metallic walls. So we shall be needing the help of boundary conditions to apply over, finding over the solution for the E and H vectors. So I hope the next lecture will describe you to get the details in more details for circular waveguide. So for more details and more information like this, you can subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you.